Biscuit Oliva, or Oliver, is one of the most well-proportioned muscular characters in manga and anime history. In fact, on several occasions, I've talked about how I personally believe he has one of the best bodybuilding types of physiques among anime characters. Which makes total sense, given that he was modeled after the likes of Sergio Oliva, who was a three-time Mr. Olympia and the last person to ever defeat our guy, Arnold, on the bodybuilding stage. He was also modeled after the mass monster that is Ronnie Coleman, who many people consider to be the best bodybuilder of all time, having won 8 Mr. Olympias. One of the things that I love about the Baki manga is the attention to detail with the muscularity of the characters, and since bodybuilding is a passion of mine, you can see why I spend so much time delving into the artwork that makes up each one of these characters. So, without further ado, let's jump into Biscuit Oliva's anatomical rating. We will start with the upper limbs, then move to the front and back torso, and end on the legs just before I give my final overall rating. So, just how accurate is it when compared to an actual human bodybuilder? Let's jump into it! As per usual, we'll start with the upper limbs, and just to get this out there, Oliva has crazy arms. When looking at the forearms, we can see some of the individual muscles being the flexors and extensors. I will say, at least from the few pictures that I've picked out of each character, I do think Yujiro's forearms have just a touch more detail, as we could essentially break down the individual muscles like our favorite, the flexor carpi radialis longus muscle. Did you try saying that one 5 times fast? Having said this, I do think Oliva's arms are a bit more well proportioned. His biceps and triceps match his shoulders and forearms a bit better. Now, when looking at Oliva's biceps, we have a weird thing going on. I think they are just showing the individual short head and long head of the biceps brachii. However, the long head almost looks more like a crazy big brachialis muscle. So this is a bit off anatomically. I'd like to see the two heads of the bicep be a little more connected and have the brachialis in there as well. Now, the triceps look pretty solid to me. We can see the horseshoe type shape to them that's created by the lateral and the long head triceps brachii. So given this, in my opinion, I think they're pretty spot on. Onto the shoulders. Like I said, his shoulders are crazy, but they actually match his arms a bit better than Yujiro's. This gives him less of a monsterish kind of feel than Yujiro, and more of a damn, this guy actually just has nice shoulders. You can see the muscle separation between the three heads of the deltoid as well, the anterior, posterior, and lateral heads. So given this, I give Oliva's upper limbs a 9 out of 10. Up next, we have his chest and abs. Oliva's chest is solid. It matches his shoulders very nicely. I do think his arms may be just a touch big for his chest, but it's nothing I'd deduct points for. His chest is also filled out very well, with the lower pectoralis major matching his upper clavicular insertion, which is just where the pec attaches to the clavicle. Moving on to his abs, the rectus abdominis pop very nicely. He has a solid six-pack and it stays muscular throughout the entirety of the torso. His obliques are pretty solid, but like Yujiro, and I'm guessing many other Baki characters, his serratus anterior muscles are just not there. They should be right here in between the lats and the obliques, but they're not. So given this, I'm going to give Oliva's anterior torso a 9 out of 10 as well. One thing I love about it is that the V-taper that is produced with the small waist and the massive lats pops out from the back. And speaking of lats, that's where we're gonna go next. And before we get to that, it would mean a lot if you would like this video, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. It will help get this kind of content to more viewers, which means more people can learn about bodybuilding, science, and anatomy. That's pretty cool. Also, I would just greatly appreciate it. Now onto Oliva's back. He has a crazy back. I've actually been looking forward to reviewing it because it's not like a demon back, it's legitimately modeled after a bodybuilding back. And because there are so many muscles in the back, many artists just miss a lot or just don't have the patience to do all of them. But that's not the case here. Oliva has an amazing back. Let's start with those traps. Their scientific name is the trapezius muscle, and they span from the neck down to the middle of the back. And I love how they open up a path around the vertebral column, specifically the C7 vertebra, which is the one that pops out the most at the bottom of your neck or the upper back. Another muscle in Oliva's back that really just pops is the infraspinatus and also the teres major muscles. These are appropriately placed and sized in this art. Two more things that really stand out about his back are the latissimus dorsi and the erector spinae. Obviously, this isn't the best picture in terms of showing these muscles, but I do love how wide the lats go and flexed the erector spinae are as he holds up his gorgeous wife. On top of this, you can clearly see the Christmas tree type shape in the lower back, which is always a good sign of muscularity and conditioning in terms of bodybuilding. Therefore, I give his back anatomy a 10 out of 10. Now, like I mentioned in my Yujiro rating video, lower limbs are a unique rating that I'll only do with certain characters because, frankly, we just don't usually see the character's legs. But with Baki, that's a different story. One thing I love about Oliva is that he clearly does not skip leg day. They match the muscularity of his upper body very well, and while I do think his calves are just a touch too big in comparison with his thighs from some of these angles, in other angles they flow perfectly well. So with the calves, there are two primary muscles. You have the gastrocnemius and the soleus muscles. We can see both are clearly defined in these drawings. From the anterior portion, we can even see the tibialis anterior, although it does look a little bit strange on the right leg. From a quadriceps perspective, we can clearly make out the three visible muscles being the vastus lateralis, rectus femoris, and vastus medialis muscles. Side note, if you're wondering what the fourth muscle is, it's actually called the vastus intermedius muscle and it runs underneath the other ones. On the posterior side of things, we can make out what looks like the biceps femoris and perhaps the adductor magnus, although they aren't extremely clear here. The gluteus maximus, though, is very visible. So from a lower limb perspective, it's also very solid. I give Oliva a 9 out of 10. Adding up all of Oliva's scores from his upper limbs, anterior torso, posterior torso, and legs brings his muscular anatomy accuracy to a grand total of a 37 out of 40. Honestly, this may be the best we see in all of anime, so high praise to the artist here. The thing that I find most impressive to me, at least, is that I didn't score any of these categories under a 9 out of 10. Which means that he's extremely proportional. To me, this is hands down one of the best bodybuilding types of physiques in any animated work, not just anime. So I'd love to know your thoughts on Oliva's anatomical rating as well as this style of video. Let me know in the comments down below. I legitimately look at every single comment for now, who knows in the future because we are growing really fast. Either way, I appreciate all of you. Now before I end this video, I thought it would be really cool to put Mr. Oliva next to the two people that inspired him, Ronnie Coleman and Sergio Oliva. I just think this is so cool because these are two of the greatest bodybuilders of all time with one of our favorite anime characters. And if you've never seen these two pose or even a bodybuilding show before, I encourage you to go look at some. It will help you learn more about the human physique, a great sport, and some of your favorite characters. But for now, make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video.